Hey everyone, and welcome to Manifestation of Imagination. Reed here, and I've got a little thing on unusual allies. Here's my cat, Philip. He's a nice little cat. Real pretty silver tabby. So he's part Siamese and has the tabby colors. And he wants me to put him down. But he's a real funny cat. He's got a disease called CH, meaning he's an absolute klutz. So let me show you. So he's a really odd and silly cat, but what's really nice about him is he's got a lot of empathy, more empathy than I've ever seen in a cat, and he really watches what's going on around about his people. Like if you come home and had a really bad day, he'll be right there wondering what's upset, why are you mad? You know, if you get in an argument with your, you know, family and friends for some reason, and you're upset and it's raw right then, he comes running and always comes asking, what's wrong? What are you doing? He loves to be my little friend. He likes to sit in my lap. I'm editing the videos. He's like, oh, I'll help keep you company. He likes to think he's helping, but all cats love to think they're helping when they're really making the job three times worse. But their company is wonderful. Now, the other interesting thing is, like, I have asthma, and sometimes my asthma acts up really bad at night. And so I'll get these dreams where I'm, like, suffocating. Well, I'm actually having an asthma attack. And Mr. Philip here is like, oh, something's wrong with you. I've got to do something. And so he wakes me up. Of course, he takes the approach that he thinks is appropriate as a cat. He's like, okay, time to bite you. Yump. And he wakes me up, and then I can deal with it. But I've never had a cat that's so aware, interested in what I'm doing, what I'm thinking, how I'm feeling, what's going on. Events in the house. He lets me know anything and everything going on in the house. It's really amazing. So I never would have expected that about him. And all the people that didn't pick him up at the shelter, well, they missed out on an amazing friend. So my point is after we get whatever terrible event is coming that's going to reset society and make us have to rebuild a great deal, we're going to have to figure out people. We're going to have people with us. We're going to have to form groups. We're going to have to work together. And if you're just looking at what you can see on the surface, you're going to miss some extremely important and valuable allies. People you wouldn't expect, people you wouldn't realize how important they really are. And so everyone has value. And if you just look at the surface, you're going to miss things. I hope this gives something for you to think about, and you can consider some unusual allies as you're considering how things are going to go, and to keep things in your mind, I mean, how you want to approach things after the collapse. So this is Reed. Hope you liked the video. Give me a comment. I'd love some discussion on this one, and hope everyone has a great day. Take care.